us, Master.
Blessed is our God, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Christ is risen from the dead, trampling down death by death, and upon those who live in bestowing life.
There is no healing in my flesh in the face of my wrath, and there is no peace in my bones in the face of my sins.
For my faithfully serving Christ, I have, as I have heard him, they have heavily upon me. I deserve from the voice of the crowd in the face of my father. I have been rushed from every bow down and again, all day long, and down with downcast face. For my loins are filled with moths, and there is no healing in my flesh. I have perfect and humble receiving it, and the glory of him is burning in my heart. O Lord, before me is all my desire, and my groaning is not yet complete. My heart's troubled, my strength is failing, the light of my eyes and the ears is not opening. My friends and my neighbors do not over against me and stood, and my hands and feet stray far off. And they that sought after my soul use violence, and they that sought evil from the same vain things of practical solidness. They long for their meditation. But as for me, like them now, I heard them not, and was as a speechless man that openeth not his mouth. And I became as a man that heareth not, and hath in his mouth the word truth. For indeed, I hope the Lord, I will hearken to the Lord my God. For I said, let never my enemies rejoice over me, yea, when my feet were shaken, those men spake boastful words against me. For I am ready for scourges, and my sorrows continue before me. For I will return my enemies, and I will take heed to them my sin. But my enemies live in theirs, and now they are stronger than I, and they that gave me unjustly are multiplied. They that render me evil for good slander me, because I pursue goodness. Forsake me not, O Lord my God, depart not from me, be as one who my heart, the Lord of my salvation. Forsake me not, O Lord my God, depart not from me, be as one who my help, the Lord of my salvation. O God my God, unto thee I rise, hurry and come, my soul hath thirsted for thee. How often have I thus longed after thee, in a land barren and untrodden and unwatered? So in the sanctuary have I appeared before thee to see thy property and glory. For thy mercy is better than life, my lips shall praise thee. So shall I bless thee in my life and in thy name. For I lift up my hands, as with marrow fatness that my soul be filled, and my lips rejoicing shall I now praise thee. If I remember thee on my bed, and on thy meditate on thee, for that before my health, then I shall be better than joy and rejoice. My soul will speak after thee, and I right hand to help me. But as for these in vain, they sought after my soul. They shall go down to the nethermost parts of the earth, they shall be surrendered unto the edge of the sword. Portions for foxes shall they be, but the king shall be God of God, and one shall be praised by some that swear by him. For the mouth of them is a saw that speaks unjust things. At the dawn I meditated on thee, for that within my help and shelter thy wings will I rejoice. My soul will cleave after thee, thy right hand, and take thee help me. Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and faith to the Son. Alleluia, 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 glory to your God, alleluia, 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 glory to your God, alleluia, 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 glory to your God. What a mercy, Lord, mercy, Lord, mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Both now and ever, and our ages of ages. Amen. O Lord God, my salvation, my being, my pride, and my life is free. Let my prayer come before thee, thou now my ears, my supplication fulfilled, but Jesus is my soul, and my life is peace. I account you with them that your gown is your fit. I may come as a man without help, free among your dead, like the bodies of the slain that sleep in the grave, and thou rememberest no more, and they are cut off from thy hand. They made me the lowest pit, they darkened sin in the shadow of death. Against me, as thy name remains strong, and all thy illness hast thou brought upon me. Thou hast removed my friends apart from me, they have made me an abomination to themselves. I have been delivered up, and have not come forth. Mine eyes are no weak from poverty. I have cried unto thee, O Lord, the whole day long. I have stretched out my hands unto thee. Nay, for the dead, what thou wilt witness, or shall physicians raise them up, that they may give thanks unto thee? Nay, shall any in the grave tell of thy mercy, and thy truth, and thy destruction? Nay, shall thy wonders be known in thy darkness, and thy righteousness in the land that is forgotten? But as for me unto thee, O Lord, I have cried, in the morning shall I hear from thee fully. Wherefore, Lord, dost thou cast off my soul and turn aside face away from me? A poor man am I, with troubles in my youth, yea, having been exalted, I was humbled and brought to distress. Thy furies have cast upon me, and thy terrors have sorely troubled me. They came round about me like water all the day long, and they compassed me about together. Thou hast removed apart from me, friend and neighbor, and my acquaintances because of my misery. O Lord God of my salvation, by day have I cried, by night before thee. Let my prayer come before thee, bow down thy ear to my supplication. Bless the Lord, O soul, and all that is within me, bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, forget not all that he hath done for me. Who is gracious unto all my iniquities, who healeth my infirmities, who redeemeth my life with corruption, who crowneth me with mercy and compassion, who fulfilleth my desire with good things. By you shall be redeemed as the evils. The Lord performeth deeds of mercy and executeth judgment for all men that are wrong. He hath made his ways known unto Moses, unto the sons of Israel, and fame of thy compassionate and merciful is the Lord, long-suffering and plenteous in mercy, not until the end of the anger, neither of eternity will be wrought. But according to thy peace, have you dealt with us, neither according to our sins have you rewarded us. For according to the height of heaven and the earth, the Lord hath gave his mercy to the elders and have given. As far as the east is from the west, so far hath he delivered from your peace to us. Like as the Father hath compassion upon his sins, so have the Lord hath compassion upon his nephew. For he knoweth whereof we are made, yet remember that we are dust. As the man who saves us, grass is a valley of years, which shall be passed before. For whatever the wind is passed over, but it shall be burned. And no longer will it then face the light. But the mercy of the Lord is from eternity to eternity upon their nephew. And his righteousness is upon sons and sons, upon them that keep his testimony and remember his commandments to do them. The Lord in heaven hath prepared his throne and his kingdom reigns over all. Bless the Lord, all you his angels, mighty in strength, that perform his word through the voice of the tombs. Bless the Lord, all you his services and his gifts that you deserve. Bless the Lord, all you his works in every place of his dominion. Bless the Lord, of my soul. In every place of his dominion, bless the Lord, of my soul. O Lord, hear my prayer, give ear unto my supplication, my truth. Hearken unto me, my righteousness, and let me not be judged with thy servant, but my sight shall no man live be justified. For the enemy hath persecuted my soul, and hath crumbled my life down to me. He hath sat me in darkness as those that are long dead, and my spirit within me is become despondent, within me my heart is troubled. I remember the days of old that I meditated on all thy works, and pondered on the creations of thy hands. I stretched forth my hands unto thee, my soul thirsteth after thee like the waters of the sea. Quickly hear me, O Lord, my spirit hath been to me. Turn not thy face away from me, lest I be like unto them that go down to me. Cause me to hear thy mercy in the morning, for in thee have I been comforted. Cause me to know, O Lord, the way wherein I should walk, for to thee have I lifted up my soul. Rescue me from my enemies, O Lord. Unto thee have I fled for refuge. Teach me to be thy will, for thou art my God. Thy good spirit shall lead me in the land of brightness. For thy namesake, O Lord, shall not be me. In thy righteousness shalt thou bring my soul out of affliction, and in thy mercy shalt thou utterly restore my enemies. And thou shalt cut off all them that afflict my soul, for I am thy servant. O Lord, give ear unto my supplication, and enter not into judgment with thy servant. O Lord, give ear unto my supplication, and enter not into judgment with thy servant. Thy good spirit shall be in the land of brightness. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, come now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Alleluia, 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 glory to the Lord. Alleluia, 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 glory to the Lord. Alleluia, 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 glory to the Lord. O my God and our God, glory to thee.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Find mercy.
For the peace from above and for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Find mercy.
For the peace of the whole world, for the good estate of the holy churches of God, and for the union of all men, let us pray to the Lord.
Find mercy.
For this holy house and for those with faith, reverence, and the fear of God unto them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our Father, Metropolitan Joseph, for the venerable priesthood, the diaconate in Christ, for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For Metropolitan Paul and Archbishop John, and for their quick release from captivity and safe return, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the President of the United States, for all civil authorities and foreign forces everywhere, especially for Peter, Joshua, Rodney, Adam, Andrew, Benjamin, Thaddeus, Connor, and Skyler, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this city and for every city and land, and for the faithful who dwell therein, for health and seasons, for abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For travelers by sea, by land, and by air, for the sick and the suffering, for captives and for their salvation, for those under persecution for the faith, for our deliverance from all tribulation, wrath, danger, necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy upon us, and protect us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Call me to our to Christ our God.
And to thee, O Lord.
For unto thee are due all glory, honor, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Transgressors of the law, O merciful Lord, nail
sacred have set in mind and praise the angels. Wherefore, O blessed Holy Lord, glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. The strange mystery, O my Savior, is become salvation for the world. For in the God, in the manner that is raised from the grave, and as God is raised up with by himself, them that have become subject to corruption. O thou life of all, O Lord, glory to thee, both now and ever as the ages of the atonement. O Theandrum, both transcended in praise, O bride, who has not tried marriage. O thou who has changed with sorrow and joy, we worship and we bring with praise. For thou that didst lift us up from the first curse, and now in the days of sympathy, O all holy one, for our salvation.
Blessed art thou, O Lord, teach me the statutes. The company of the angels was amazed when they beheld me numbered among the dead. Yet myself was Savior destroyed the power of death, and with thee raising the battle, and releasing all men from hell. Blessed art thou, O Lord, teach me the statutes. Wherefore, O women disciples, lead me with sweet sonnets, vices, with pictures of piety. The radiant angel witness the sepulchre cry, unto the murmuring women, behold the grave and the Christian, for the Savior is risen from the tomb. Blessed art thou, O Lord, teach me the statutes. Very early in the morning, with the murmuring women, thou lamenting unto thy tomb. But an angel came to order, saying, the time for lamentation is past. Weep not, but announce unto the apostles the resurrection. Blessed art thou, O Lord, teach me thy statutes. The murdering women, mourners bearing spices, they drew near thy tomb, O Savior. But the angels spake unto them, saying, why are we the living among the dead? In that he is God, he is risen from the grave. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. We adore the Father, as also the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Holy Trinity in one essence, crying with the seraphim. Holy, holy, holy art thou, O Lord, both now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. In that thou didst bear the giver of life, O Virgin, thou didst redeem Adam from sin, and didst give to Eden a place of sadness. And he who was incarnate of thee, O God and man, that restored to life those who have fallen therefrom. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. O Lord God of your hope, glory to thee.
Again and again in peace, let us pray for the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy upon us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
All in your remembrance, our Holy Immaculate, most blessed and glorious Lady, Theos, Opus, Never, Virgin Mary. With all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and our whole life unto Christ our God.
Blessed is thy name, and glorified is thy kingdom, of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen. The minds of the
orphan
bear with them, and the doubts of thy
my soul from the deceitful eyes. Verily the wild dwellers of the wilderness is very happy, for by divine passion are they ever carried out. Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, for now and ever and to the ages of ages. By the Holy Spirit are all creations, seen and unseen, preserved, the control thereof being in himself, who is without doubt one of the Trinity.
Come, my soul, let us ascend thou to the
and said to the disciples, I have seen the Lord, and she told
mercy on me, O God, according to thy great mercy, and according to the multitude of thy compassions, blot out my transgressions. Wash me thoroughly from my iniquity, and cleanse me from my sin. For I know my iniquity, and my sin is ever before me. Against thee only have I sinned, and done the secret of joy. Thou mightest be justified in thy words, and prevail when thou art judged. For behold, I was conceived in iniquities, and sins did my mother carry. For behold, thou hast loved truth, and hidden in secret things, and thy wisdom hast thou made manifest unto me. Thou shalt sprinkle me with discipline, and I shall be made clean. And thou shalt wash me, and I shall be my own self. Thou shalt make me your joy, gladness, the bones that be humble, they shall rejoice. Turn thy face away from my sins, and blot out all my iniquities. Pray me a clean heart, O God, and do a right spirit within me. Cast me not away from thy presence, and take not thy Holy Spirit from me. Restore unto me the joy of thy salvation, and with thy governing spirit establish me. I shall teach transgressors thy ways, and the ungodly shall turn back unto thee. Deliver me from blood guiltiness, O God, thou God of my salvation, and my tongue shall rejoice in thy righteousness. O Lord, thou shalt open my lips, and my mouth shall declare thy praise. For thou hadst desired sacrifice, I have given it. With over and offering thou shalt not be pleased. A sacrifice unto God is a broken spirit, a heart that is broken and humble, God will not despise. Do good, O Lord, in thy good pleasure of Zion, and let the walls of Jerusalem be built up. Then shalt thou be pleased with the sacrifice of righteousness, with oblation and whole burnt offerings, then they shall offer bullocks upon thine altar.
Glory to the Father,
and
to the Son.
Exalt the horn of Orthodox Christians, send down upon us thy rich mercies. Through the intercessions of our All Immaculate Lady Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary, by the might of the precious and life giving cross, by the protection of the honorable vitalist high powers of heaven, at the supplications of thy honorable glorious prophet Corner Baptist John, of the holy, glorious, all wonderful apostles, Peter and Paul, and of all thy holy apostles, of our fathers among the saints, great hierarchs and ecumenical teachers, Basil the Great, Gregory the Theologian, and John Chrysostom, Athanasius, Cyril, and John the Merciful, Patriarchs of Alexandria, Nicholas of Myra, Spiridon of Prometheus, Nectarius of Pentapolis, the wonder workers, of our fathers among the saints, Tikhon, Patriarch of Moscow, Raphael, Bishop of Brooklyn, of the holy, glorious, great martyrs, George the Trophy Bearer, Demetrius the Mirth Streamer, Theodore the Soldier, Theodore the General, and Venus the Wonder Worker, of the higher martyrs, Ignatius the God Bearer of Antioch, Arlampos Eleutherios, of the holy, glorious, great women martyrs, Thecla, Barbara, Anastasia, Catherine, Deviaki, Cortini, Marina, Oreska, Bernarine, of the holy, glorious, right, victorious martyrs, of our venerable and God-bearing fathers who shone in the ascetic life, St. Barnabas, the patron and protector of this holy community, of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, of the virgin martyr, Glycerio, of Hierolachia, the venerable Sergius, the confessor, father of Clodius the Great, the venerable Euthymius, the new founder of the Ivory Monastery of Anaphos, as Father John the Iberian, their kinsman George, the venerable Gabriel the Iberian, whose memory we celebrate today, and of all thy saints, with many beseeds thee, O most merciful Lord, hearken unto the petitions of us sinners who make our supplication unto thee. Have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Yana Borum, Yana Borum, Yana Borum. Kyrie eleison. Ostrigo mi, Lord.
Through the prayers of our Holy Fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and save us.
Born blind, and in repentance I cry to thee. Of those in darkness thou art the most radiant light. Grant me a stream of ineffable wisdom and knowledge on high, O Christ. Thou light of them who are in darkness, and guide of all of them that are gone astray, that I may tell of those things that the divine book of gospel of peace has taught, to wit the miracle that was wrought upon the blind man. For through though blind from birth, they receive the physical eyes as well as the eyes of the soul. As you cry out in faith, of those in darkness, thou art the most radiant light.
On May 13th, the Holy Orthodox Church, we commemorate the Virgin Martyr of Lycuria and Heraclea, the Venerable Sergius the Confessor, Father of Motios the Great, the Venerable Euthymios the New, and founder of Iberon Monastery in Athos, his Father John the Iberian, and his kinsman George, and the Venerable Gabriel the Iberian. On this day, the sixth Sunday of Costa, we celebrate the miracle wrought by our Lord and God and Savior Jesus Christ upon the man who was blind from his birth. O light of life most perfect and light provider, on the blind from birth, O Word, eyes thou bestowed. The Savior met this man born blind and incurable after every human effort while leading the temple on the Sabbath. Saints John Chrysostom, Basil the Great, and Irenaeus teach that this man was born without eyes. Jesus spat into the dirt, made clay, rubbed it in his eye sockets, and told him to wash in the pool of Siloam, a famous water spring in Jerusalem. The Savior did not send him there because his eye sockets were covered in clay, nor did the pool have healing power, but instead to test his faith and obedience. The blind man proclaimed that Jesus healed him, but this confession caused him to be cast out by the enemies of the truth. Even his own parents did not defend him. However, the blind man followed Jesus from that moment forward. By thy infinite mercy, O Christ our God, giver of life, have mercy on us. Amen.
Let us praise our God and only Savior.
Hear ye now thy word, O Lord, and the lights of thy cross, through which carry thy
the Pharaoh of the cross and the mother of the light, let us honor and magnify in song.
Save us. Amen. For he is our Lord, our God. For he is our Lord. And the fear of God entered therein,
Let us pray to the
Lord.
Your Father, Metropolitan Joseph, the venerable priesthood, the diaconate in Christ, for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the
Lord.
For Metropolitan Paul, Archbishop John, and for their quick release from captivity and safe return, let us pray to the
Lord.
States for all civil authorities and for armed forces everywhere, especially for Peter, Josh, and Ronnie, Adam, Benjamin, Andrew, Thaddeus, Skylar, and Connor. Let us pray to the
Lord.
For this city and for every city and land, and for the faithful who dwell therein, for healthful seasons, for abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times. Let us pray to the
Lord.
Travelers by sea, by land, and by air, for the sick and the suffering, for captives and for their salvation, for those under persecution for the faith, for our deliverance from all tribulation, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy upon us, and protect us, O God, by your grace. Our all holy immaculate, whose blessed and glorious name fills all us, and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
For unto thee are due all glory, honor, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Now and ever and through ages of ages.
Son of God.
Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy upon us, keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
All in your remembrance, sorrow, holy immaculate, most blessed and glorious, may death, O Christ, Virgin Mary. With all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and our whole life with your Christ our God.
For thou art a good God, who lovest mankind, and unto thee we ascribe glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Stand upright.
Thank you.
in those days, as we apostles were going to the place of prayer, we were met by a slave girl who had a spirit of divination and brought her owners much gain by soothsaying. She followed Paul and us, crying, "These men are servants of the Most High God who proclaim to you the way of salvation." And this she did for many days. But Paul was annoyed and turned and said to the spirit, "I charge you in the name of Jesus Christ to come out of her," and it came out that very hour. But when her owners saw their hope of gain was gone, they seized Paul and Silas and dragged them into the marketplace before the rulers. And when they had brought them to the magistrates, they said, "These men are Jews, and they are disturbing our city. They advocate customs which it is not lawful for us Romans to accept or practice." The crowd joined in attacking them, and the magistrates tore the garments off them and gave orders to beat them with rods. And when they had inflicted many blows upon them, they threw them into prison, charging the jailer to keep them safely. Having received this charge, he put them into the inner prison and fastened their feet in the stocks. But about midnight, Paul and Silas were praying and singing hymns to God, and the prisoners were listening to them. And suddenly there was a great earthquake, so that the foundations of the prison were shaken. And immediately all the doors were opened, and every one's fetters were unfastened. When the jailer woke and saw that the prison doors were open, he drew his sword and was about to kill himself, supposing that the prisoners had escaped. But Paul cried with a loud voice, "Do not harm yourself, for we are all here." And he called for lights and rushed in, and trembling with fear, he fell down before Paul and Silas and brought them out and said, "Men, what must I do to be saved?" And they said, "Believe in the Lord Jesus, and you will be saved, you and your household." And they spoke the word of the Lord to him and to all that were in his house. And he took them that same hour of the night and washed their wounds, and he was baptized at once with all his family. Then he brought them up into his house and set food before them, and he rejoiced with all his household that he had believed in God.
Peace be to thee that readeth.
Some said, "It is he." Others said, "No, but he is like him." He said, "I am the man." They said to him, "Then how were your eyes opened?" He answered, "The man called Jesus made clay and anointed my eyes and said to me, 'Go to Siloam and wash.' So I went and washed and received my sight." They said to him, "Where is he?" He said, "I do not know." They brought to the Pharisees the man who had formerly been blind. Now it was the Sabbath day when Jesus made the clay and opened his eyes. The Pharisees again asked him how he had received his sight. And he said to them, "He put clay in my eyes, and I washed, and I see." Some of the Pharisees said, "This man is not from God, for he does not keep the Sabbath." But others said, "How can a man who is a sinner do such signs?" There was a division among them. So they again said to the blind man, "What do you say about him, since he has opened your eyes?" He said, "He is a prophet." The Jews did not believe that he had been blind and had received his sight until they called the parents of the man who had received his sight and asked them, "Is this your son, who you say was born blind? How then does he now see?" His parents answered, "We know that this is our son, and that he was born blind. But how he now sees, we do not know, nor do we know who opened his eyes. Ask him, he is of age, he will speak for himself." His parents said this because they feared the Jews, for the Jews had already agreed that if anyone should confess him to be Christ, he was to be put out of the synagogue. Therefore his parents said, "He is of age, ask him." So for the second time they called the man who had been blind and said to him, "Give God the praise. We know that this man is a sinner." He answered, "Whether he is a sinner, I do not know. One thing I know, that though I was blind, now I see." They said to him, "What did he do to you? How did he open your eyes?" He answered them, "I have told you already, and you would not listen. Why do you want to hear it again? Do you want to become his disciples?" And they reviled him, saying, "You are his disciple, but we are disciples of Moses. We know that God has spoken to Moses, but as for this man, we do not know where he comes from." The man answered, "This is a marvel. You do not know where he comes from, and yet he opened my eyes. We know that God does not listen to sinners, but if anyone is a worshiper of God and does his will, God listens to him. Never since the world began has it been heard that anyone opened the eyes of a man born blind. If this man were not from God, he could do nothing." They answered him, "You were born in utter sin, and you will teach us?" And they cast him out. Jesus heard that they had cast him out, and having found him, he said, "Do you believe in the Son of God?" He answered, "And who is he, sir, that I may believe in him?" Jesus said to him, "You have seen him, and it is he who speaks to you." He said, "Lord, I believe," and worshipped him.
Because he always said them, and they still had a power to put my troubles to rest and to bring clarity, I think, back to my faith. Life can get so complicated, you know, or maybe it's more accurate to say we can complicate life so much with our own negative thoughts, our doubts, our fears, that even such a simple reminder of God's love is abiding love and his active care in our lives acts as a kind of reset button, you know, for our soul. Always remember that God loves you. Perspective, how we look at things, is not necessarily reality, but it can certainly affect how we view reality and therefore, in a sense, what reality is to us. We can see God in our lives, or we can miss him entirely, simply by the matter of perspective and the orientation of both our mind and our heart. The scripture lessons today give us two examples of this, which are really polar opposites. In our reading from Acts 16, we find Paul and Silas in prison for the alleged crime of casting a demon out of a young girl. For this outrage, they have been beaten bloody and placed in chains in a dark and lightless cell. Yet they were not found weeping and lamenting their fate, but praying and singing hymns to God. Then came the earthquake, which opened all the cell doors and caused the chains of the prisoners to fall off. We know what happened after this. Eventually, of course, at the end of the story, the jailer came to faith in Jesus Christ and ministered to the apostles, washing and binding their wounds, and he and his entire household were baptized.
This in turn led to the founding of the church in Philippi and the salvation of many souls. From a dark and seemingly hopeless prison cell flashed a great light that illumined many. A person inclined toward disbelief, a negative perspective, would likely see no miracle here. Everything was just a series of coincidences. Obviously, the jail was not up to code, the earthquake code, and when the building shook, the brackets that held the chain fell off, and all the doors came off their hinges and swung open. This random accident just happened, of course, to perfectly serve the gracious and loving will of God. And that's just mere coincidence, right? Well, you know, disbelief sometimes takes more effort than simple belief to conjure a story that explains it all away. The second act of God's love we heard this morning also involves a lot of explaining away, though much more difficult, really, task. Didn't envy the Pharisees in trying to toss this one off. But the healing of the man born blind, the Pharisees did not rejoice in this divine act of mercy, but sought desperately to deny it. Now, of course, these were the religious leaders of the day. They were the folks that were supposed to recognize God, the actions of God in the midst, and celebrate them. But there was no champagne and confetti on that day. Their deep and visceral envy of Jesus Christ caused them to close their eyes to an obvious miracle. There was only one explanation. The man was healed. He had been given new eyes. He who had been born blind now could see. They, the Pharisees, were the ones who were struck blind, while the one man received his sight. And all by one and the same action. Just a matter of perspective. One saw, others couldn't. And this is exactly perspective, what our Lord was talking about when he spoke of the eye being the lamp of the body. If your eye is good, meaning your perspective, the way you see things, the way you perceive life, then your whole body will be filled with light. But if your eye is bad, then your whole body will be filled with darkness. How you see yourself, your God, your world, and the people around you fills you either with darkness or with light. Remember, perspective is not reality, but it certainly affects how you engage reality and the joy or the sorrow that you experience in life as a result. Just a matter of how you see things. If your eye is good or if your eye is bad, regardless of your perspective, regardless of how you see yourself or others, this much is true. God loves you. You are a fallen person in a fallen world, but God sustains you and all the world by his mercy. Things are not as bad as they might be because God mitigates the evil that is in you and in the world around you. You know, people sometimes when they see an earthquake, some disaster, they say, how could a good God let this happen? They don't realize that we're still here because we have a good God. I'm sure this world and we ourselves, the devil, would have destroyed everything a long time ago. God's grace and God's mercy is all around us all the time. That things are not as good as they could be, but they're certainly not as bad as they could be either. What do we expect in a fallen world? But for our sake, if we do not see things, if we do not see God, if we do not see God's mercy, if we spend more time being discouraged than being hopeful, then perhaps there's something wrong with our eye. We need to go to the eye doctor over here, the confessional. Oh yeah, two. You got two eyes, two confessionals. We don't always live in the joy of the Lord because we don't see his care. We may live in sins because we don't see the glory that we could have in our lives. We don't, we live with anxiety and troubles and worries, and we think that's just normal, that's just part of life. No, it isn't. But we feel that way because we don't see God's care. We don't believe that he will take care of us. We see no solution to our problems in life because we only see what we want and not what we already have been given. Life can be hard. You know, it's the same life. And some people seem to go through it joyfully, and some people go through it miserably. And perhaps it has to do with their eye and how they see. But always remember that God loves you. Let that become your perspective, your abiding perspective. Always remember that God loves you. Let Jesus give you sight, heal your eye, and fill your whole body with light. The glory of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Help us, save us, have mercy upon us. Keep us, O God, by thy grace, wisdom.
Let our heart always, by thy might, we may ascribe glory unto thee, through the Father, and through the Son, and through the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Desires and pleasures of the flesh is worthy to approach to a draw not and to serve thee, we give you glory. For to serve thee is a greater peril than even the heavenly powers. Nevertheless,
all of you. May the Lord God remember in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages. President of the United States and all civil authorities and our armed forces everywhere, the Lord God remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages. For the Orthodox servants of God, especially for the Archpriest Wayne and his family, for Kevin, Colleen, and their family, for Shelley and their family, for Allison, Mary, Rudy, and Stacy and their newborn, for Gary and Emily, and for Donald, for Aubrey, Sophia, Christina, Nadia, Angela, Destiny, that they have mercy, life, peace, health, salvation, visitation, pardon, and remission of their sins. O God, remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages. For the Orthodox servants of God imparted this life, especially for Michael, for Elmer, for Adelaide Victoria, and for Asina. Lord God, remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of
and the fear of God into therein, let us pray to the Lord. For our deliverance from all tribulation, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. Holy, peaceful, and sinless, let us ask of the Lord. Angel of peace, a faithful guide, a guardian of our souls and bodies, let us ask of the Lord. Pardon and remission of our sins and transgressions, all things good and profitable for our souls, and for peace in the world, let us ask of the Lord. That we may complete the remaining time. time of our life in peace and repentance, for a Christian ending to our life, painless, blameless, peaceful, and a good defense before the awesome judgment seat of Christ, let us ask of the Lord. Calling to remembrance our all holy immaculate, most blessed and glorious Lady Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God. Love one another, that with one accord we may confess.
Bring us from non-existence into being, and when we have fallen away, his grace is up again.
and is not ceased to do all things, until thou hast brought us back to heaven and hast endowed us with thy kingdom which is to come. For all these things we give thanks unto thee and to thy only begotten Son and thy Holy Spirit, for all things of which we know and of which we know not, and for all the benefits bestowed upon us both manifest and unseen. And we give thanks unto thee also for this ministry which thou hast vouchsafed to receive in our hands, even though there stand beside thee thousands of our angels and the thousands of angels, the cherubim and the seraphim, six winged, heading high, soaring aloft, borne on their pinions, singing the triumphal hymn, shall be proclaiming and saying,
Rejoice, rejoice,
Sit on high with the Father, and are here invisibly present with us.
and vouchsafe by thy mighty hand to impart unto us thy immaculate body and precious blood, and through us unto all of you.
O God, be gracious unto me, a sinner, and have mercy upon me. O God, be gracious unto me, a sinner, and have mercy upon me. O God, be gracious unto me, a sinner, and have mercy upon me.
Let us attend.
Holy things are for the holy.
Thank you.
must be persuaded Orthodox Christian in good standing, having made a recent confession and having prepared yourself for things.
With the fear of God, with faith and love, draw near.
Son of God,
save thy people and bless thine inheritance.
Christ is risen from the dead, trampling down.
Thank you.
money with his grace and love for his man, always now and ever and unto ages of ages. Glory to thee, O Christ, our God, and our hope, glory to thee.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Now and ever and unto ages of ages. Amen. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Risen from the dead, Christ our true God, through the intercessions of his all-immaculate and all-blameless Holy Mother, the might of the precious and life-giving cross, the protection of the honorable bodiless powers of heaven, and the supplication of the honorable glorious prophet, forerunner, and Baptist John, of the holy glorious and all-honorable apostles, of our Father among the saints, John Chrysostom, Archbishop of Constantinople, whose divine liturgy we have now celebrated, of the holy, glorious, and right victorious martyrs, of our venerable and God-bearing fathers, of Saint Barnabas, the patron and protector of this holy community, of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, of the virgin martyr like Curia of Heraclea, the venerable Sergius the Confessor, father of Photios the Great, the venerable Euthymios, the new founder of the Eberron Monastery on Athos, and his father, John the Iberian, and their kinsman, George, the venerable Gabriel the Iberian, whose memory we celebrate today and of all the saints. Have mercy upon us and save us for as much as he has put in our hearts. Christ is risen from the dead, trampling down death by death, and upon those in the tomb.